Hey guys, I'm Lillian, aka Stitching Me, on Instagram and here on YouTube. Thank you for joining me. I hope you find something of interest. Before we get into the good stuff, I would like to ask for your help real quick. I will make it really short. Because I am looking for a good program for charting patterns. Now, I am currently using a free program. I was like, just give it a shot, but it's not working like it's supposed to, and it's just too frustrating to work with. So if you have any experience with charting on a computer and you would like to let me know what you thought of that particular program. I can't English today. So please let me know in the comments down below the pros and cons of the program that you used or are using. It will really help me out just to make sure that I don't put an investment into a program that's not working either. So yeah, please help. Thank you in advance. So that out of the way, for today I have two whips. I have a knitting finish. Well, no, wait, I have a whip and a finish, a cross stitching finish. Then I have a knitting finish and a knitting new start. I have finished my diamond painting, which I forgot to grab. Oh my god. Okay, I will probably pause the video or something, we'll see. But I have finished the diamond painting. More of that in a second. And if we have time left, I will probably go into an update for Etsy. So, stitching. Like I told you last time, I set my goals for this month way too high, so I had to adjust them in the beginning. And those adjusted goals have been met. So that's great, because, oh, I forgot to tell you the date. It's the, I don't know the exact date, but it's Sunday and it's almost the end of November. So, which one should I do first? Yeah, Amazing Lady. So, I'll take it out. This is Amazing Lady. Don't mind the red shoulders, please. I don't know what my printer was thinking. It's not that red, I promise. So my goal for this month, well, no, my goal for this piece in general is to finish it before the birthday of Eileen, and Eileen is the person I'm stitching it for. Park the threads. So, and to do that, I have to do about 25 blocks of 10 by 10 stitches per month. So in this case, it basically was equal to 3 rows. So I had done about 3 rows before this month started, and I have finished my goal of another 3 rows for this month. And I have added the first purple, I think there are flowers. I really like that. It's coming together nicely. And then my goal for next month will be another 3 rows. So about to there. That's all going to be hair still. And then after that, there will be shoulders. So probably like the 3 rows will not be my goal for the month after December, like January. because the rows are getting wider. So I need to do less rows to finish 25 blocks, if you will. Oh, and I forgot all the information again. Let's start over, shall we? This is 18 count white Ada. 2 over 1 full cross. All called for DMCs. And then you might think, what is this random magnet doing here? Well, I'm testing the magnets that I ordered for my needle minders. And I will talk about more about the needle minders in the end of the video when I talk about Etsy. So that is Amazing Lady. Then my finish. So, okay. I'm so not prepared. Every time I think I'm prepared, but I'm not like prepared, if you will. This is a set of three animals that I got from Etsy. And I'm stitching these for my boyfriend. And I started out with the bear, which is now finished. And I will do the wolf next. So, and I'm doing one a month. So this was my goal for November to finish. This will be finished in December and this will be finished in February. So that in 'Did you see like a loading symbol on my forehead? Well, okay. This was the goal for this month, December and January, not February. And then I will have the whole month of February to finish them, like fully finish them, to give them on his birthday on the 5th of March, if I pronounced that right. Yeah, probably. So, here is the bear. This is the same fabric as Amazing Lady. So, 18 count white Ada. It's 2/1 full cross, called for DMCs, all the same. And again, testing the magnet. I really like the magnets so far. Like, they are strong enough to hold the needle, but they don't like clamp onto the needle. If you want to grab it, you can easily take it off. So, that's the bear, right? That's all I have to say about that. Yeah, basically. That's fast. Again, need to stop being surprised. So, knitting. First of all, I have finished this shawl. Now, I was not expecting this to actually be a triangle, but it is. So, there it is. But yeah, almost a perfect triangle. So, that is the shawl. I don't know if I will wear it. It's really bright, but it might work with some pieces of clothing. And yeah, we'll see. This is not really exciting, but this means that I can, when I have time, cast on the first square for the blanket that I'm knitting for Eileen, same friend as for my Amazing Lady support. So that's exciting. I showed, if you're curious for the wool and the like the yarn that I will use, the colors, I showed those in my last video. And I got a question. Oh, I forgot her name. Never mind. You will know when I'm talking about you. So she asked me to show if I could show how I knit with bended needles. Because I bend my needles purposely. These are bendable. It's really weird, but yeah. So I bend them slightly. Why? Because if I stick one under my arm, it's not like, it doesn't end up here, but it ends up in the middle in front of me. So I don't have to, it helps reducing back pain. So what I like about putting a needle, one of the needles under my arm, is that I can let go of the needle with my hand. So when I'm not stitching continental, so I'm holding the working yarn in my right hand, I can let go of the needle and wrap it around without the needle moving too much. So I hope that's enough of a demonstration. If not, let me know. I will probably like try to explain more or something. Let me know if this was enough. so that's the finish. Will I keep it on? I'll keep it on. Then what I started was the pair of socks that I will knit for my boyfriend, because it's pretty much getting wintry here, and there's a chance that he might, well, he will, let's be confident, he will do an internship in a zoo, and so he will do a lot of work outside, so if it gets cold, his feet need to stay warm. And now Gina will be like, but it's not that cold in the Netherlands. I know, compared to Alaska, it will not be that cold, but still cold to us. So this is the sock that I'm starting, and it's black, so the texture is not really showing up. But this is basically the same as my dad's. So two purl, two knit ribbing, and stockinette. I'm doing 30 rows for the stockinette, or rounds, I should say. And yeah, this is the wool. Not that exciting. But that's knitting. Let's see. Diamond painting, right. Okay, let me pause you. Please hold. There we go. I hope this is correct, because I don't know how to edit. So I will not be able to put them together if this didn't work out, but yeah, we'll see. It is recording again, if I'm right. So this is the diamond painting. I did not show it before because it was almost done right before when I filmed my first video. It was almost done already, but I started this, really enjoyed it, and then I found out about the lack of detail that these drills give. It doesn't look that bad on camera, but in real life I prefer the stitching look, because you can make each stitch so much smaller, and then it will not be this pixelated. So I might do another diamond painting sometime in my life again, but not anywhere soon, not in the near future. There's a drill stuck in the border. Okay. What can I tell about this? Not that much, right? I got it at a fair. The same fair where I got Twilight Bridge. Yeah. So that's it. I'll show it once more. I still have to take a picture for Instagram. That's it. Okay. That's enough for the diamond painting. So that's all crafty stuff. We will go into Etsy now, so if you don't want to hear that or you're not interested, that's fine. I'll see you next time. So first of all, I will go into the stitching related Etsy plans. And just for the record, my Etsy, I know there's a lot of bracelets and stuff right now in there, but I do plan on making it a strictly like, well, not strictly, but very, very primarily stitching related. And then there will be some crochet stuff. I plan on selling like hand crocheted baby clothing and stuff. But so the niche will drastically change. Don't worry, it will all be stitching and crochet and stuff. Okay, so the most exciting plan is my very first pattern. Like I told you before, I made my first pattern, and Gina was really kind and wanted to do the model stitch. So she has done her model stitch. I also have done a model stitch, because there will be two choices as far as colorway goes. I will not show you the pattern yet. I will show you once it's done, because now we need to take the pictures, make the PDF, and make the listing. But that's not all, because I want to, because I always do more. I cannot like contain myself. It's so bad. But okay, there will be a needle minder with corresponding features. It will not be like matchy, but it will have corresponding features, and I will put it up to go with the pattern. So I want to put them up on Etsy around the same time, or basically at the same time. So before the pattern can go up, I have to finish the needle minders. Now that's not too much too difficult, because I have already ordered everything I need, and this, as you have seen, I have already what are they called? Magnets are already here. So once I get all the supplies, then I have to make them and take pictures and then make a listing. So it's really close to being done, but also really far away. It can be next week, it can take another month, but I do hope to put it all up on Etsy before the new year. Dry mouth. So that's really exciting. Then there's another pattern. I've already made my second pattern, and Gina is model stitching that one as we speak. So that's really exciting. I feel so professional having an actual model stitcher that's not myself. It's, yeah, like I don't even have stitching stuff on my Etsy yet, but I do have a personal helper, like model stitcher. I feel professional, okay. I feel professional, I'm proud of myself. So, and they will both be very positive vibes and be really simple. There will only be full crosses and backstitch. Really beginner friendly, yeah, really simple. I'm also planning on like converting some pictures that I take myself, converting them into patterns and maybe put them up on Etsy. Let me know if you're interested in that, because I'm just too late for the fall colors, but that's fine. Maybe we'll get snow and then I can take some pictures with the snow, and otherwise I will have to wait until spring for some flowers to come out, but never mind. Let me know if you're interested in that. Okay, so that's all the stitching related plans for Etsy. Well, there are way more plans, but they have not been started yet. It's for like making the products and stuff, so I will not go into those any further. Okay, so there are a few new listings up on Etsy. Why I put those up, they are not stitching related, so why I put those up was basically because I already had made them, so it was really a little effort for me to just put them up and see if they will sell, because I kind of am on a budget because I'm a student, so I decided to only use income that I get from Etsy to invest in more stuff for Etsy. So I figured that if I could sell the stuff that I put up, then that profit I can use to, for example, buy the program I need for the patterns and supplies and stuff. Okay, so what I put up, first of all, I put up a scrunchie, a fabric scrunchie that was, like, I showed it in my last video. If you want to see it, go there. I will make more because someone, I will not name her because I don't know if she wants me to name her, but she, like, I was watching my phone and one second I got a notification that she had subscribed to my channel. Then I got a notification that was like 5 favorites from her in my Etsy shop. And then I got a notification that she had ordered a scrunchie. So thank you so much for the support. It really made me so excited. I was literally jumping up and down here. It was really hard not to scream. So yeah, thank you for that. It's too warm. I'll take it off. So I sold that. I had just one in inventory, so it now says sold out, and it feels so, I don't know. It looks nice. Like, I've sold out. Like, damn, they went so quickly. But never mind. Okay, I sold that. There will be more coming. And then I put up another scrunchie, which was this velvet crochet scrunchie. Those have not been sold yet, but never mind. And then I have also put up these bracelets, and I've all shown these before. So I will take it and go through this really quick. Like these macrame, if it will focus, please. Thank you. Bracelets, and there are several beads that you can choose from. So you can choose the color, black or white, and you can choose the beads. There are several beads. There's an option for best friends, like these hearts. So then you get two bracelets. I have infinity signs, I have flowers, I have hearts, I have lots of stuff. So if you would like to support me and to increase the rate in like the way I can improve and invest in Etsy, so that I can actually make it a stitching shop, go check it out. I am kind of thinking of adding the buy me a coffee link to the description. It will not be there for this video, at least not yet. Well, not for this video, but maybe like next video. But I don't want to. I totally can relate with Amy. She said that like she doesn't want to sound like she's screaming for like begging for money, but I'm not. I'm just like, if there is someone out there that would like to support me and my shop, but they cannot find a product that they like, then they can just buy me a coffee, and then that money will go into Etsy, and I will like make sure to always tell you what I buy with the money that I get from that. But I don't know if I'm an established enough channel for that yet. Let me know, what do you think about that? I mean, I can just put it up and see, like, if nobody buys me a coffee, that's fine. But okay, enough about that. I think that is it. I think it is. Yeah. So my Instagram is the same as here on YouTube, but with an underscore between Stitchy and me. So Stitchy underscore me is my Instagram. I will put a link. Feel free to contact me either in the comments down below or on, if you want it to be a private message on Instagram. And happy stitching!